A'udzubillahi minasyaitonir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih kepada pengacara dan
khususnya kepada peserta sekalian yang sedang berjuang untuk menjadikan perkahwinan mereka satu syurga di dunia dan akhirnya membawa itu syurga itu ke akhirat, insyaAllah. Juga terima kasih kepada speaker-speaker yang lain yang sudah memberikan kekuatan kepada kita bercakap tentang prevention, bercakap tentang solution. Dua benda yang two main things. If you do prevention, normally you have solution or not? You need solution or not? Go, if you prevent things not to be, so there's another solution, anak. Kalau kita sudah jaga pokok elok-elok, ada masalah tak? You take care your marriage in good manner, best manner, there's, ada masalah lagi tak? Ini ada marriage problem lagi tak? Ada divorce lagi tak? Ada macam-macam lagi. Tak ada, betul tak? So we focus on how to develop and how to maintain. Maybe that's a mean of solution. Okay, so kita kata tadi kita dah bercakap, what I'm saying is the main thing in order to develop whatever thing you plan, either marriage ke any other plan pun, atau ini ada tempoh ataupun ini ada kita kata agenda pun, first thing you must know, who am I, who are you, okay, who are you, where are you going to, what bekal-bekal you kena bawa. Dan akhirnya who you met at the end of the day. This format harus lekat dalam kepala. It must stick in you. Saya siapa? Saya Muslim. I'm a lady. I'm Muslim lady. I'm Muslimah. If this registered in your mind, registered in your feeling, in your spiritual, you will go on acting like a Muslimah. Not only the dressing, not only the jubah. Because we are represent ourselves in four angles. First is your physical fitness, your physical look. So you taking care of the physical, but not thinking what's the internal of you, your internal, external, external, your IQ again. So always ask, who am I? As a husband, who am I? What is my main duty? What is my contribution? What is my impact if I do and not doing? Maknanya sekali lagi kita nak bangun sebagai orang yang nak kita katakan wanita yang jadi isteri. Okay? Terlalu banyak makanan kesehatan nak bagi kurus, nak bagi cantik. Betul? Putih. Tapi tak ramai yang ada makanan nak bagi cantik imannya. How to polish my iman with God? How to make my jalur lebar to God? Kita tahu alamat sini tak ada internet lah. Cepat-cepat kita tahu. Tapi kita tak tahu internet kita dengan Allah jalan tak? Kita tahu orang tengok kita. Apa tengok-tengok? Dia tengok-tengok saya. Tapi kita rasa tak God is looking at you all the time? Sebab itu pegang sini, ada jantung anda. Betul atau tidak? Jantung tak pernah berhenti pun berdenyut. Siapa yang buat? Siapa yang pegang? Who are in charge? Itu kalau kita menilai balik, saya hamba Allah. Okay? The whole thing dari rambut sampai kaki is God's. Gift is not me. Lend to me and then be taken back later. That's the frame. Sebab itu kita kata antara nak cakap tentang prevention and solutions, it's not only for the lady and the both, not lady only, but the man also need to be improved, need to be to have solution, isn't it? Maka sekali lagi, being ladies, pertama kita kata develop back. How? What do I think? All the time being wife, what do I think? All the time as a worker, what do I think? Every day, ask yourself, what do I think now? Ya Allah, teruknya doktor tu, English ni teruk sangat. Kenapa dewanya gelap sangat macam dalam gua? Is it positive thinking? Is it make you good? It given energy to you? Charges your concentration? No. Just be happy, lantaklah apa pun. Sebab saya tahu saya hamba Allah. Yang penting saya tak lukakan orang, saya tak sakitkan dia orang, dan saya tak rendahkan orang. Sebab itu sebagai seorang isteri, sebagai seorang kakak, sebagai seorang ibu, ladies ni banyak jawatan kan? Sebagai seorang sahabat, always train yourself. Saya hamba Allah yang tak boleh lukakan hamba Allah yang lain, terutamanya suami. Syurga pada suami. Tapi suami yang macam mana? Suami yang taat Allah, taat Rasulullah. Suami yang implement all the order from God dan tinggalkan semua yang dilarang. Sebab itu sekali lagi bercakap sebagai hamba Allah, kalau your action, your thinking, your feeling, your spiritual and your action all the time carrying the aku hamba Allah, aku muslimah, anda orang selamat. Anda orang selamat. You are safe anywhere you go. Itu sama. Yang kedua kita kata, kalau kita kata kita prevent, macam mana? Bagaimana kita nak bangunkan nilai muslimah dalam diri kita sebagai karakter? How to impose yourself. Saya ni muslimah. What kind of character that you have? I being muslimah. Kalau kata saya jadi isteri, maka kita kata kita jadi anak soleha, isteri soleha, jadi ibu soleha. So the duty for the husband. Kalau anda ditakdirkan berkahwin, tolong develop the wife to be isteri soleha. Tolong bangunkan, because syurganya sudah berpindah pada anda. Sebagai suami. Sebab itu suami yang complain. You cannot do this. Tempat tadi belakang kata, tempat Tuan Syekh kata, not a man. Dia bukan orang. Dia bukan suami. Sebab itu seorang suami, tugas besarnya, how to save. Sebab itu surah At-Tahrim ayat 6. Wahai suami, wahai lelaki, lindung diri kamu, anak isteri kamu, dari api neraka. Betul? Kekuatan ini dipegang. Kalau pegang ayat ini saja, ya Allah, tak ada marriage yang gagal. Suami pegang 100%. Tolong selamatkan diri kamu, anak isteri kamu. Save yourself, your wife, your children, so that they can reach jannah by your hand, with your hand, with your whole. Kekuatan ini nak dipegang. And then hadis Rasulullah kata apa? Setiap anak lahirnya bersih. Kalau kita anak lahir bersih, jadi isteri pun bersih, jadi ibu pun bersih, so what? Apa sebab jadi salah? Kalau kamu dilahirkan jadi, dilahirkan anak, setiap bayi dilahirkan bersih. Mak dan ayah jadikan dia jadi Majusi, Nasrani dan Yahudi. Sekarang anda sudah jadi ayah, anda sudah jadi ibu. What is your function? To make sure that your children, if not as good as you, better than you. Tapi kebanyakan kita, our length ni pendek. Sebab itu most schools, what you want to be? Nak jadi doktor. What you want to be? Engineer. What you want to be? Accountant. Tak ramai yang kata, I want to be a Muslim. I want to be a good Muslim accountant. Saya nak jadi accountant beriman. Sebab itu bila ditanya cita-cita, what is your vision? What you want to be? Saya nak kaya, nak hebat, nak itu, nak popular, nak. Sangat sedikit nak kata, saya nak jadi calon syurga. Saya nak jadi khalifah yang Allah redha. Ni kekuatannya. Berapa ibu tanamkan pada anaknya, kamu ini khalifah nak selamatkan agama. Bukan nak selamat kamu saja, bukan nak selamat perut saja. You are the one who will lead the country to save the religion. Sebab itu kita tak masuk pun dalam otak kita. Semalam saya di keluar Johor, di sebuah sekolah, sambutan Maulid Rasul. Okay. Kita tanya, apa sebab kita sambut Maulid Rasul? Tak tahulah cikgu suruh. They not even know why they celebrate Muhammad birthday. Okay. Kalau itu tak tahu, ada makna tak? Is it meaningful to have the celebration? Apa ciri-ciri Rasulullah yang kamu ingat? Adalah seorang berdua, jujur. Okay. I want you to say jujur this time. Berapa orang tak solat subuh pagi ini? 90% tak solat subuh. Pada jam 6, jam 5, jam 4. 10 years old, 11, 12. Wajib. Subuh! The parent is around. Mean the parent also? Kong kali kong. Betul atau tidak? So again, pada saya. Prevent your children so that they know, they feel, they want to be Muslim. Not only the kerjaya, not only the job, not only the profession, not only the status, not only the popularity, not only the kaya. Sebab itu, kalau itu dapat diselesaikan, insyaAllah, kita merupakan orang yang paling kuat untuk membaca, kita kata, bagaimana kehidupan perkahwinan yang saya mahu. My marriage punya vision saya dalam perkahwinan, saya nak jadi isteri yang paling banyak masak untuk suami dan anak-anak. Tapi kerana siapa? Siapa masak di sini? Angkat tangan. Who cook personally? Okay, kenapa masak? Kenapa masak? Sorry lah, gelap ni, saya tak nampak. Okay, why you cook? For whom? Untuk siapa? Lapar! Jadi saya masak for my stomach. I do cooking for my husband and my children. That's the most common answer. If that's only the vision, so memasak cooking is no more ibadah. Okay? Saya masak kerana Allah. Untuk anak-anak dan suami. Sebab itu baru datang doa, ya Allah, yang makan ini esok jadi ya. Calon syurga, ya Allah. Yang minum kopi ini calon syurga, ya Allah. Yang makan ini calon syurga, ya Allah. Baru masak jadi ibadah. Baru cuci pinggan jadi ibadah, ya Allah. Sebab itu tolong bagi tahu dengan anak, you are Muslim. Different than any others. Different halnya, different karakternya, different dressingnya, different readingnya, different reference-nya. All different. Dia boleh, saya tak boleh, no. Sebab itu ada Islam, ada Muslim, ada takwa tiga lagi. Terus tak. Kekuatan ini nak dibangun. Tapi kita selalunya kata apa? Agama tak jadi basic. Sebab itu pada saya, if you handle your marriage based on wahyu, definitely happiness. Tapi if you lead your marriage with nafsu, kong kali kong. No, you can't go anywhere. You can't reach the goal. Sebab itu orang boleh cakap, we can easily say, saya kahwin kerana Allah. Saya buat kerana Allah. This year saya bagi kerana Allah. Next year, dulu aku bagi. Sebut lagi. Okay. Dulu saya dah buat baik dengan anda 20 tahun. Ini kebalasan. Kerana dapat tahu isteri suaminya poligami. Betul-betul tidak. Dia ungkit semua. So, sekali lagi, kalau kita kata prevention, kita harus membaca dan melukis love map kita. Peta cinta kita. Peta cinta tak pernah ditulis dan tak pernah dibuat jadual. Sebab itu, kita akhirnya hilang cinta. Yang datang counseling, yang datang ke klinik, doktor, saya tak pernah dihargai. Kenapa kamu perlu penghargaan? Itu motivasi. Ya Allah. Suami saya balik diam je. Sebab itu suami ni ada berapa kuatan je sehari? Satu hari dia ada 5,000 atau 6,000 sahaja. Orang lelaki perempuan, Allah bagi kemampuan bercakapnya 120,000 perkataan. Sebab itu ladies never stop talking. If ladies not talking, that means he's not feeling well. Non-stop talking also. Ada simptom lain. Oleh itu sekali lagi, balik semula. Develop your marriage with wahyu. It's not with nafsu. Itu yang pertama. Kedua, pegang balik hadis. Pegang balik surah At-Tahrim. Jadikan itu vision. Ya Allah, saya nak bawa anak dan isteri saya. Saya ni masuk syurga tak? Kadang-kadang ayahnya suruh anak buat, tapi ayah tak buat. Kadang-kadang isteri solat, suami tak solat. Pengalaman suami tak solat sangat ramai. Sebab itu sekali lagi bangun balik kekuatan. Determine the values. Saya nak anak saya jujur, saya nak suami saya jujur, saya nak isteri saya jujur. Cakap elok, betul kat ni. Bila nak latih jujur, tak ada suspicious, tak ada buruk sangka. Okay? Betul tak ni? Cakap betul sikit, betul ni. Kalau ayah tipu, minta maaf. Anak keturunan tipu. Kalau anak, kalau ayah tidak jujur, minta maaf. Anak garanti boleh bohong ayah dia. Itu satu daripada sebab mengapa keluarga Islam ataupun jadi kita isteri namanya Islam tapi tenggelam macam kapal selam. Nampak? Maka sekali lagi bangun kekuatan. Saya diberi 40 minit. I don't know how long that can get. Siapa pernah petakan cintanya? Kahwin minggu, tahun pertama berapa, tahun kedua berapa, tahun ketiga apa? Kalau tak ada peta ini, anda nak treatment yang sama pada anak dah dua, anak dah tiga. Suami masih nak, okay bang, ni kopinya. Kan ni dah ada anak ramai ni. Ada suami jealous dengan anaknya. Kamu sibuk dengan anak je, sebab itulah aku kahwin. Astaghfirullahalazim. Anak siapa? Ada husband jealous dengan mak mentuanya. Ada pasangan, Allah macam-macam. Kena sebut dengan panjang nanti, tak cukup 15 minit. Okay. Saya mohon tolong buat jadual percintaan anda. Masa tak ada anak macam mana caranya? Ada anak macam mana? Do agreement. Awak setuju tak benda ni? Kalau masa tak ada anak, you do, you tak payah washing, tak payah buat air, tak payah makan. Bila dah ada anak, okay, you do washing, I do hanging. Betul tak? So, awak basuh, saya ampai. Awak persiang ikan, saya masak. Mana boleh silang kaki lagi? You are the wife. Kerja rumah untuk isteri. Siapa kata? Empat-empat imam setuju. Tugas masak adalah tugas suami. Empat-empat imam mazhab bersetuju. Tukang cuci adalah suami. Percaya ke tak? Nak angkat ke tak? Jangan main-main. Cooking is not ladies, not wife punya tugas. Men's, suami punya tugas. Sebab itu bawa balik makanan yang sudah dimasak. Jangan bawa ikan mentah-mentah, ha, masak. No, that's not my duty. Sebab itu kami tak boleh layan isteri. Jadi raja. Sebab itu kalau suami sudah sediakan makan bermasak, maka pakaian sudah siap gosok untuk isteri. Rumah sudah siap kemas. Baru suami balik, ahlan wa sahlan. Betul ke tidak? Baru boleh layan macam ratu, macam raja. Ini kita bersilat nonai-nonai tanpa cuti, tanpa MC. Suri rumah. Apalagi yang bekerja, dua-dua penat, dua-dua kerja ya. Dua-dua balik bawa. Sebab itu one seminar pernah dibuat di Kuching. Bring your heart home. Dari rumah tinggalkan anak, cantik. Sebab itu dikatakan, kalau isteri pakai baju cantik, dia nak pergi mana? Di rumah ke di luar? Keluar. Nak ikut, nak ikut, nak ikut ke tanah dia. Sebab mak dia di rumah tak pernah cantik. Itulah malangnya anak hari ini. Tidak pernah tengok maknya cantik di rumah. So, isteri solehah. Cantik di luar, cantik juga di dalam. Sebab itu dipesan, kalau anda mahu istri anda macam Khadijah, tolonglah suami jadi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Kalau tidak, jangan mimpi to get the best wife but you not the best husband. Betul? Beside that, untuk prevention, every ladies must have skill and knowledge. Your degree, your sigil, your diploma, pung sana. There's nothing to do with your marriage. That's only to get job. But when you start marriage, open a new book. How to this, how to that, how to cook, how to keep, how to... Tidak. Kebanyakan perkahwinan jadi masalah kerana isteri dan suami tak mampu didik anak dengan baik. Saya tak biasa tidur lambat, saya tak tahu baju susu, saya tak tahu bendung, saya tak tahu ini, saya tak tahu ni. Banyak sangat tak tahu. Isteri paling banyak tahu di rumah. Tapi suami sesat di rumah. Stokin tak boleh cari. Mana stokin? Ay, stokin. Lelaki belah kiri. Mana ada? Tak ada apa. Kan masalah. Take care of your dragon, take care of my dragon, take care of children. That's it, senang. Ini sebab tak sama. Kita rasa kerja ini ke rumah kita ke rumah dia? Kita duduk di rumah kita ke di rumah dia? Rumah? Kita, so kita share lah order kita. Ni anak kita, ni anak kita. Bangun, tolong tukar pampers, tukar jajajajaj. Kadang sampai nak pergi lantai ada pampers anak. Pampers anak penuh ni, ha? Penampar baru begitu. Betul atau tidak? So again, kalau kami dah bawa dia 7 bulan, 8 bulan, 10 bulan, 9 bulan, 10 hari, anda nak bawa bila? The minute the baby born, you are the one should carry. Ini keluar hospital. I tak tahu. Kecil sangat, tak tahu. Mandi kan, maybe. I tak boleh. Itu semua. I cannot. Mumpuk pun tak. So, all this lacking. No knowledge, no skill. How? How to go on living? Buat susu anak sekejap. Tak tahu berapa berapa seduk. Learn every single thing needed by your children. So that you share the burden, you share the responsibility. And then you can call my darling. Kalau tidak, just my partner. Kalau tidak, just kawan-kawan. So the respect tend to be less. Tapi kalau anda layan dia, sayang dia, beri perhatian pada dia, macam anda baru kahwin, tidak ada isteri putus asa. Bukan nak duit pun. Wah, sedap rasanya. Thank you cooking for me. Alamak, hebatnya. Susah ke nak puji? So, isteri tanda hadiah lah. Cantik dia pakai baju macam ni. Hari-hari dia pakai baju tu. You masak asam pedas sama sedap lah. Hari-hari masak asam pedas. Tak pensan. Kerana we need also attention. We need sharing and we need caring. Jangan hanya serah bulat-bulat. Bila isteri tak bercakap, no problem. Tak bercakap makna problem. Selagi dia boleh cakap, dia okay. Kalau balik rumah dia tak boleh bercakap, mean not okay, ma'am. So learn woman's brain. We can think many things at one time. But men only think one thing at one time. Dia suruh bila tinggal rumah, dia lupa rumah. Betul tak? Dia jumpa orang lain, dia lupa isteri dia. Tak lepuk ke sikit? Okay, kekuatan. So develop your strength. First, your knowledge. I know what kind of treatment to be a newborn baby, toddler. Sampailah ke peringkat teenagers. You know, problem, tahu solution, tahu. If you can understand the problem, you can get the solution. That's why sometimes counselor is needed. Okay, next week, I will be tanyalah ustazah. Bercakap pentingnya counseling keluarga. Takut jumpa counselor. Lelaki sebut counselor. I tak ada problem, you yang problem. Dia tak tahu ke isteri problem sebab dia, betul tak? Just come lah, just send lah. Bukan nak bunuh pun. Doktor, suami saya mati, tak naknya pergi jumpa kaunselor. Okay, bila kita terpaksa, you sayang suami isteri tak? Kalau you sayang isteri, tolong bawa. Sometimes the isteri come first. And then they go with the husband. No, ne. You look okay, ya? Ha. So come, I bring you to her. Perempuan pula tu, eh? Ini prejudice je malakan. So, sekali lagi. Kalau anda sudah siapkan giving the right thing, bagi hak, jalan tanggungjawab, that's it. Apa saja hak isteri, bagi, tak payah tuntut. Okay? Kami isteri menuntut hak pakai kain rentang, tak payah. All the suami, hak-hak isteri sudah jelas dalam Al-Quran. Satu surah An-Nisa, pegang isteri nak apa. Kalau isteri sudah bagi, diberi haknya, isteri sudah jalan tanggungjawabnya, we have no problem, man. Betul. Sometimes the husband want the treatment, wah, the best treatment, but he never give any good thing. Makan belum? Nasi ada tak? Kenapa tak masak? Just question, inquire itu, inquire ini, but never give. So what you never give, you never receive. So happiness bukan duit, happiness bukan harta. Kalau tidak, mana boleh mungkin chairman Hyundai Korea terjun tingkat 33 sedangkan gajinya 3 juta sebulan. So jangan kata cantik boleh pikat isteri, no. Cantik apa yang boleh, isteri jangan sibuk cerita cantik untuk memikat suami. Okay? Cantik isteri tidak mampu menahan suami untuk cari girlfriend. Kalau setakat putih di putih, langsing, langsing. Okay. Kita selalu tinggal, how do I manage my mind? What's the best proper words should I say to my husband? If I am tired, what words should I use to make him helping me? Okay, darling, ya Allah. Kemarin dulu, last year you masak sedap sangat. Can you repeat the cooking, anak? Boleh ke tak? Setahun sekali masak, gila. So, tempat paling popular ialah dapur. Jadi suami yang baik, kalau tak ke dapur, potong kakinya. Tak cukup baik. Okay, every man, every husband kena tahu mana periuk, mana sudu, mana garpu, mana pisau. Pisaunya mana? Besennya mana? Oh, semua tak tahu. Duduk luar je lah. Maka, bercakap tentang prevention, pertama, equip you with knowledge. And then, equip yourself dengan skill. Whatever skill. Okay? Cooking skill, eating skill, talking skill, skill. Ngemeh ni skill, macam-macam. Betul tak? So, sekali lagi, for whom? Kita buat untuk siapa? Bukan untuk suami, very sorry. Saya buat untuk Allah sebab Allah sudah bagi awak jumpa saya. Bukan saya buat syukurlah awak pinang saya ke tidak tahu jadi anda tu saya. No. Jodoh dari mana? Dari Allah. Minta maaf banyak. Itu untuk saya. Thank you very much. Saya ada 15 minit. Kau nak tanya apa-apa? Ada? Itu kalau ada, tak ada, okey je. Sudah dapat skill, sudah dapat knowledge. Apa lagi nak dapat? Develop your best meaning in life. Saya jadi isteri awak, awak rasa macam mana ya? Biasa je. Betul atau tidak? Dulu badannya besar ni, sekarang jadi besar ni. Berat dah kereta. Betul. Ada suami, isteri yang sangat besar. Sakit tak boleh angkat dalam kereta. Akhirnya meninggal di tepi rumah. Kerana terlalu besar. So, suami boleh cakap lah, jangan besar sangat ya. Jadi, awak jangan bagi makan sedap-sedap. Kalau sedap, makannya banyak. Makan sikit-sikit sudah. Betul? Umat Nabi makannya sikit. Kan? Nabi makannya sikit. Nabi makannya sikit. Umat Nabi sikit-sikit makan. Betul tak? Okay. Nabi tidurnya sikit. Umat Nabi yang mengaku umat Nabi, sikit-sikit tidur. Dalam dewan tidur ni gelap. Bukan nampak Azrah. Nabi cakapnya sikit. Tapi yang mengaku umat-umat Nabi, tak berhenti. Cakap. This three character. You need to improve. Talk only necessary things. Talk and happy joy manner. Bang-bang. Rasa-rasa besok kita berkeloh kat luar. Kenapa? Berasnya dah habis. Yang kata kenapa tak beli itu? Kenapa? 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 Sebab pakai ini. Bila anda mula perkataan siapa, mengapa, ada apa? You only using your thinking. Your IQ. Salah. Ini salah. Ini betul. Ini salah. Your IQ. IQ cannot develop love. IQ cannot develop love. Okay. Sebab itu engineer kahwin dengan doktor, cerai. Sebab tak ada joy. isteri saya tak boleh gurau. Doktor bila nak gelak. Ada tak jumpa doktor kita gelak? Assalamualaikum, apa khabar? Dah lama ke sakit? Ada? Ada. Dia straight forward, one to one two. Tak ada lain. Kita ada one to one 11, ada. Betul tak? Bila tak ada happiness dalam bentuk gelak, ketawa, penat weh. Sebab itu isteri peguam menderita. Isteri lawyer menderita. Isteri hakim menderita. Sebab kebanyakan mereka tinggal di library. Lebih banyak. Bawa makanan ke library. Bawa kopi ke library. Sebab nak clearkan kes orang salah jadi betul. Kan letih. Sebab itu, yang belum ada partner, yang belum kahwin. Ada yang belum kahwin? Semua sudah kahwin. Syukur Alhamdulillah. Kalau yang belum kahwin, jangan cepat-cepat jatuh cinta. Cari sebab mengapa aku jatuh cinta dengan dia. Kalau setakat handsome ni saja tak mampu untuk cinta kita seumur hidup. Okay? Kalau setakat jawatan saja tak mampu sebab bersara. Ini pesara dia sekarang. Sudah bersara dan takut sengsara. Sebab itu buat aktiviti.
Boleh nampak?
Ketiga, kalau kaya. Kalau kayanya untuk kita tak apa. Dia ada warisan. Ada anak, ada itu, ada ini. Jangan kerana kayanya kita layan dia luar hidup. Boleh itu sekali lagi. Develop your IQ. Just 30% for your happiness. And then, the main thing, develop your EQ. Emotional quotient, 70%. Plus, your spiritual quotient. Emotional quotient, how to develop? Always ask yourself, what feeling that I'm talking now? How do my feeling now? Do my word will hurt her feeling or not? How to upgrade my feeling? How to motivate my pre-feeling so that I can develop other people feeling? We never talk about it. Perasaan sedih, doktor. Tapi tak boleh cakap. Saya tersinggung tapi saya tak nak cakap. Doktor, saya simpan 20 tahun, doktor, sedih. Bodoh, saya kata. Kenapa simpan? Betul atau tidak? Serik, serik. Tadi awak cakap macam saya rasa terhina. Mak awak memang tak pandai ajar awak. Saya tak pandai tapi jangan cakap mak saya. Serik! Kalau perkataan-perkataan itu melukakan anda. Tak nampak sayang. 30 minit dah. Ada 10 minit. Ini first time seminar room. Contoh. Minta maaf lah orang tak pandai seni. Dia buat macam mana kan? Baru nak adopt dengan seni. Okay. So, bila dah ada skill. Ada knowledge. Implement. Pakai. Buat. Try and error. Sebab itu saya kata sekali lagi. Buat anda punya love map clearly. Saya kenal suami saya ni banyak mana. Dia kenal saya banyak mana. Apa makanan kegemaran suami? Siapa sahabat terbaik suami saya? Siapa kawannya? Dia di pejabat sebagai apa? Dia gajinya berapa? Wah, boleh tanya. Siapa tahu gaji suaminya? Semua isteri tahu gaji suami? Tahu. Tak ada gaji. Ya Allah, dia minta cerai terus. Contoh. Artinya, we know more than physically, I mean the appearance of your husband. Tak janji cukup makan. Apa warna dia paling suka? Dan kita kena ingat, suami kena faham apa yang melukakan isteri, apa yang melukakan suami. Kalau semua ini sudah dijaga, solatnya bagaimana? Zikirnya bagaimana? Qurannya macam mana? Sebab itu tidak ada family yang akan happy dalam hidupnya kalau Quran tak ada. So come back to emotion. Anaknya tak face, tapi tak boleh get senyum pun. Emotionnya sakit. Sebab itu, data gila di Malaysia naik 2.3 di kalangan wanita. 2.3%. 3 orang wanita, 1 gila. Boleh nampak? Mental sickness, sakit mental, disorder. Yang datang ke kalung kaunseling saya bukan tua, baru 18, 17, 22. Tak tahu. Kamu nak buat apa tak tahu. Kamu nak cita-cita apa tak tahu. Because the mind is not more working with the feeling. Your feeling, they no more connecting with your mind. So take care of your feeling. Always ask, what kind of feeling that make me happy? What kind of feeling should I carry to make me happy? Jangan make me sad. What kind of feeling that make me sad? So throw it out. Ketiga, check how close you are with your God. Bila kita rasa paling dekat dengan Tuhan? Siapa nak jawab? When we feel as close as with God? Solat. That's common answer. Satu solat berapa minit? Paling banyak 10 minit. Kalau tidak, normal hitung panjang, majority 5 minit. Betul? 5 kali 5, 20. 5 minit. Allah bagi berapa? 24 jam. Kita hanya rasa dekat, close dengan Allah hanya setengah jam. Tak even setengah, 25 minit. Layak tak jadi hamba Allah? Layak tak? Tak layak. Kalau Allah pegang kita 24 jam, jantung never stop. Satu minit oksigen tak masuk, jantung tak pam darah ke otak, mati otak. Kawan saya, doktor berhentikan jantungnya for just 1 minute. Half of the memory gone. Because the blood cannot carry the oxygen. Means God never ever leave you alone. Allah love is given to you every second, not every minute, not every day. This question need to be geared into your thinking. Aku dekat ke jauh dengan Allah? Allah tengok aku, aku tengok Allah. Allah ingat aku, bagi aku rezeki, bagi aku oksigen, bagi aku macam-macam. Betul? Apa oksigen bagi pada kita? Apa oksigen bagi pada kita? What the oxygen contribute to us? Life. Betul? Ada jawapan lain? Life. Kenapa di hospital ada banyak oksigen tapi mati? The hospital 1,000 ton, tentang tank of oxygen, but so many patient pass away, die. Apa sebab? Jawab je lah, bukan aku gantung. This one is very common sense question. Ajar, siapa buat ajar? Siapa yang matikan? Siapa yang hidupkan? Tadi kata oksigen. I ask you just now, what the oxygen contribute to life? War, action. Jawapan itu memutuskan hubungan anda dengan Tuhan. Oksigen adalah makhluk. Makhluk tak boleh hidupkan makhluk. Apa oksigen bagi pada kita? Tak boleh jawab pun. Oh. Sebab itu ya hayu ya qayyum, betul? Yang menghidupkan siapa? Allah. Yang mematikan siapa? So check back your connection. Check back your jalur lebar. Your internet line with Allah. Ya Allah. Kekuatan ini yang nak dibangun. Supaya kita merasa these three quotient, IQ, EQ, SQ must be blend together so that it put in the best bowl, mix in better manner. Kita ada intellect, intelligent Einstein. Betul? Kita ada art, seorang Maradona, pelakon. We have God in our spiritual. Blend intelligent, harmony, good feeling with God, you will be the most happy person here and ever after. Sebab itu sekalian bangun kok, ada 5 minit last call. Ada apa nak tanya? So bangun balik. Prevention yang dibuat akan membantu anda merasa what is happiness. Apa dia happiness sebenarnya? Kalau tadi ditanya apa itu sabar, sabar bukan silang kaki. Sabar berbuat dan selesaikan masalah. Contoh, apa itu syukur? Bukan tanda tangan, syukur. Work itu syukur. Sebab seorang istri yang bersyukur, bersyukur jadi istri, bersyukur jadi hamba Allah, bersyukur jadi ibu, orang itu calon syurga. Sampai syukur di nampak syurga. Tapi bukan mulut. So act the whole of your mind, the whole of your soul. Sebab itu kita ada jasad, ada roh. Maka mudah-mudahan kekuatannya nak dibangun. Prevent yourself. Jaga diri supaya tidak jatuh apa yang namanya kufur. Kufur nak nikmat kufur, macam-macam kufur ada. Betul? Jaga diri supaya anda tidak lakukan yang salah. Kalau salah cepat-cepat, ya Allah, ampun ya Allah. Tadi salah cakap dengan suami, ya Allah. Tadi tak doa dengan suami, tadi tak terima kasih dengan suami, ya Allah. Bantu aku, ya Allah. Syukur. Bukan syukur. Alhamdulillah. Kalau itu budak tak sekolah pun tahu. Boleh nampak? Dan yang ketiga, anda merasa bahwa anda hidup dengan wahyu. Anda hidup dengan wahyu. Tanya balik, ya Allah, nampak orang jual tudung. Ui, cantiknya, nak belilah. Tanya balik. Di rumah ada berapa banyak tudung? Nampak baju fashion baru. Di rumah ada berapa banyak baju yang tak pakai? Itu lawan nafsu. Kalau ini dapat dikawal, insyaAllah. Sebab itu bandingkan diri anda dengan orang yang paling dekat dengan Allah. Jangan bandingkan anda dengan orang yang jauh dengan Allah. Sekali lagi, sebagai hamba Allah, tidak ada repeated strength, tak ada. Tak ada ulang nak hidup balik semula, tak ada. Kita tak ada lagi second chance. So before leaving, ingat, dunia adalah tempat menyemai. Dunia tempat anda pungut harta. Semua orang sudah ada harta, tapi nak bawa balik harta yang mana? You have your material. You have your money, you have your food, you have your good name, you have your strong whatever. Tapi nak bawa balik jumpa Allah apa? Yang menunggu kita dikubur hanyalah amalan. Kalau baik, orangnya menunggu baik. Kalau tak jahat, orang yang menunggunya jahat. Busuk dan sebagainya. Oleh itu sekali lagi, bangun balik kekuatan. Saya nak jadi isteri pertama. Bukan taat dengan suami. Taat dengan Allah dulu. Kalau apa suami cakap salah di mata Allah, sorry darling. That's wrong. Awak kalau pakai tudung macam orang tua. Baik buka tudung, awak nampak muda sikit. Nantang-nantang. Isteri soleha. Dia tahu apa hak Allah, apa hak suami. Kalau sudah jaga hak Allah, hak suami otomatik terjaga. Mudah-mudahan. Ini merupakan sebahagian hanya peringatan dan perintah. Untuk merasa, pertama saya cantik. Berapa orang cantik isteri kan? Berapa orang rasa dia cantik kan? Astagfirullahaladzim. Tak ada yang angkat tangan. Itu tandanya belum bersyukur. Bila kamu belum bersyukur, takutnya kufur. Hati-hati. Dia dekat aja nak jatuh kufur. Kamu syukur, aku tambah. Kamu kufur, aku tarik. Betul tidak? Siapa cantik? Allah. Susahnya nak terima. Siapa handsome katanya? Syukur alhamdulillah. Suami handsome, suami ganteng kata orang Indonesia. Itulah suami impian. Betul? Tapi kalau ganteng secakap di dunia, hebat di dunia, akhirat kosong kong. Masuk tong sampah. Kita nak suami kita bukan saja nampak hebat di sini, tapi lebih hebat di sana. Wahai suami, bimbing isteri untuk jumpa Allah, dekat dengan Allah. Terima kasih dengan Allah atas apa yang dikurniakan, terutamanya jasad ini. Ramai orang tak bersyukur dengan wajah. Ramai orang tidak bersyukur dengan matanya. Sebab itu ramai orang tidak bersyukur dengan tangannya. Bila ditanya, "Wih, kamu pakai jam ya? Siapa pakai jam angkat tangan?" Ada tak orang pakai jam? Anda pakai jam tak? Ada. Pakai jam siapa? Jam siapa? Yang angkat tangan dia. Anda pakai jam kan angkat tangan? Di last season. Ada minit lagi. Okey, anda pakai jam siapa? Jam saya lah, dapat dari mana? Jawablah, bukan hukum gantung. Beli di kedai, pakai di tangan siapa? Dapat tangan dari mana? Bagi ke pinjam? Kalau berpinjam, dengan kuhak sendiri. Jadi tangan-tangan siapa? Tangan Allah. Pinjam. Pakai jam di tangan siapa? Tangan bagi pinjam, bukan tangan saya, tak payah tunjuk penumbuk.
Ini tangan pinjam dari Allah. Ini mata pinjam dari Allah. Jangan tengok yang Allah larang. Ini telinga pinjam dari Allah. Jangan dengar yang gila-gila. Ini kaki pinjam. Oh, saya baru sakit ankle, jalan dan macam pinjam ni ya Allah. Bagi aku pinjam sikit lagi je ya Allah. Contoh, kalau rasa jantung ini pinjam, kalau rasa hati ini pinjam, kalau rasa dari rambut sampai kaki pinjam, boleh sombong tak dengan peminjam? Boleh action tak dengan peminjam? Boleh kedekut tak dengan peminjam? Syukur Alhamdulillah, umurnya sudah hujung-hujung, dapat bonus 3 tahun sudah. Bahagia tak? Manfaatkanlah, sebab mati ada pada setiap umur. Wahai suami, walaupun isteri anda muda dari anda, belum tentu anda mati dulu. Siapa nak suami-suaminya nak isteri mati dulu, katakan. Kalau anda suami isteri nak apa? Anda dulu ke isteri dulu? Yang pegang botol, jangan minum sekarang. Okay, anda dua orang, kalau dapat pilihan, anda dulu nak mati ke isteri mati dulu? Oh, sama-sama tak boleh. Yang dah satu je. Tak tahu. Because tak tahu, we need to inform Allah. Let us have a big more moment, happy moment that we have now. Boleh tidak? Ya Allah, berkahkan kebahagiaan kami ya Allah. Kami tak tahu umurnya berapa ya Allah. Jadi kali ini nikmat terbaik untuk kami, jumpa syurga-Mu ya Allah. Baru doanya bahagia. Ya Allah, bagi rezeki, bagi pangkat, bagi itu, bagi letih kan. Jadi sekali lagi, istri adalah harta terbaik seorang suami. Hadiah terbaik seorang suami dari Allah adalah istri soleha. Okay? Amanah terbaik seorang suami dari Allah adalah istri. Maka genggamlah amanah ini, supaya anda nanti dapat tempat terbaik di mata Allah dan di sini. Terima kasih perhatian. Mohon maaf tetap kena dimaafkan di hati. Yang cantik izinnya Allah, yang tak cantik adalah turunan saya sendiri. Jadilah istri yang gembira, bukan cantik, tapi istri yang bahagia. InsyaAllah bila anda bahagia, anda membahagiakan orang lain. Sekian, wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin, wa afdalu salati wa atammu taslimi ala sayyidina Muhammad خاتم الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. It's really a great honor to be here. جزاكم الله خيرا to the organizers for inviting me to be in Malaysia once again. And it's been really a very busy last couple of days, but alhamdulillah, very, very amazing experience for me, alhamdulillah, to have met such wonderful people. And after listening to Sheikh Musa's and Imam Afroz's talks, I'm kind of wondering what I'm doing here, because, mashallah ta'ala, they have covered so much of what I wanted to say. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, reward them, and all of you. Jazakumullah khairan. So we're going to be speaking about the secular challenge of challenges to spirituality in marriage. And alhamdulillah, it's really a great reminder, first and foremost to myself, because sometimes we get so engrossed in our worldly experience, and that we forget the ultimate reality of the hereafter. We forget that there is that point in time that will exist where we will actually depart from this world. The angel of death will come, and that time will never be delayed for even a second, and take our souls, and then we will meet the ultimate reality of standing before our Lord, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with the message to wake us up to this ultimate reality, to not get immersed in the worldly existence and forget the existence of a creator, and not to associate partners with him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so the worldly desires become so overwhelming, And that we get so immersed, it's like a hole that we cannot get out of sometimes. And so this rat race for the dunya, unfortunately, is that wheel that just carries on and on and on. And so what we need to return to, and this was mentioned by Imam Afroz, the spiritual dimension of ihsan. Because if you do not have this ihsan, the spirituality, you're a dead person. You might be outwardly performing all of the acts of prayer and fasting and doing all of these wonderful acts of worship, but if you don't have the spiritual connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're dead. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the likeness of one who remembers his Lord and the one who does not is as the likeness of the living and the dead. So imagine how many people out there, they're breathing in and out, yet their hearts are dead, because the true life is the life of the heart. The day that you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the day you were born. And so how much of our existence we have wasted, and we have just let go in heedlessness, and forgetting that ultimate reality. And so what we need to, inshallah ta'ala, do is to reconnect with that spiritual aspect of us, because all of us, every single person, affirmed and recognized Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all affirmed, we recognize, and this is why every human being, when they're born on that natural disposition that inclines and believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this rat race for the dunya will never end. At what point will you say, this is enough? At what point will you say that I have enough? Because the true wealth is really the wealth of the soul. The one who has contentment has everything. Because the kings of the world, the presidents, the multimillionaire who has all the wealth at his hands, has all the gold in the world, if he wants more and more, can you actually say that he's happy, that he's content? But rather he feels there's a deficiency in him, the lack of contentment. And so if you're content with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends you, then you are the richest person on the face of this earth. And this is a great beauty of connecting with the spiritual aspect of our religion, is that we realize these realities, that we wake up and that we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if we see Him. This is the beauty of this tradition, is the spiritual aspect. Otherwise, it is just laws and rules, and it's empty. What brings you to life is the dhikr and the invocations and the connection to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your obedience to Him and abstaining from all that He's asked you to abstain from. This is where happiness lies. Why do people work excessively beyond what is required? Actually, because they want money. They think that it will remove their anxieties in life, that they will be happy. But the person who has it all, who has everything, right, who has the gold, the wealth, the cars, the houses, everything, you name it, and yet that person is still unhappy, because material possessions were never meant to give you happiness. In fact, they probably give you more anxieties and worries. Right, they were never meant to be a source of happiness. The happiness lies in the heart. It lies in your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when you make that connection, then in marriage, you will fulfill everything that is required of you. Plus you will do more. You will show excellence of character in emulation of the great character of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will actually embody this rahmah, this mercy that he represented, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You will forgive, because it's a great virtue which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so beautifully manifested. you will exemplify the most beautiful and excellent traits in emulation of the best of creation. This is the beautiful aspect of turning to spirituality and connecting with our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The one who has found Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has everything. There's no comparison. Honestly, this dunya does not compare to what you have found, what you have of that connection with your Creator. As it said so beautifully, what has he lost who has found you, O Allah? And what has he found who has lost you, O Allah? You have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have greater than the treasures of this world. And so this is a reality that we really need to tap into, inshallah ta'ala, to make our existence in the life of this world meaningful, inshallah ta'ala. And so with that, with all of the tribulations that can affect a marriage, and in line with following the beautiful etiquette and adab of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I want to look at some character traits and qualities that are really commendable and virtuous for females, inshallah ta'ala, that can help us in our married lives, inshallah ta'ala, and actually in life in general. In all aspects of life, if we have virtuous character, beautiful traits, we have ihsan, we have spirituality, this will actually impact all our social relationships in the most beautiful and best of ways, inshallah ta'ala. Now, with regards to one of the things that I want to look at, the first thing, inshallah ta'ala, I know I have here on this...
Have you moved on to...
Yes, we have, alhamdulillah. I want to look at the idea of respect, inshallah ta'ala, because if you have respect, no matter what disagreement you have or something that you do not see eye to eye from time to time, you will never have turbulence in your marriage simply because you hold your spouse in a respectful way. It doesn't mean that because there's some disagreement that he's your enemy. It doesn't mean that because we don't see eye to eye, there's some huge marital problems. No, that respect, even in times of disagreement, we never lose the respect for our spouse. We hold our spouse in the highest of regard. We don't challenge, and actually some of the points that I'm going to mention equally are for the males and husbands, that obviously my focus, inshallah ta'ala, being a female speaker, I want to just focus on that, inshallah. And also, some of the things that I mentioned in the recent interview on Friday, ICAM FM interview, some of the points that I mentioned there are quite relevant actually for what I want, for this subject also. And so, another, inshallah ta'ala, I want to talk about is the idea of patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the patient people. As I mentioned in the interview, there's no human being on the face of this earth that is not without problems and difficulties. So problems do come. It doesn't mean that we have to rush or run for a divorce or walk at the door. It doesn't mean that, because how do you not know that if you now escape that marriage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to send you some other difficulty? This life is not paradise, that we're not going to have any calamities or tribulations come our way. And so there's great wisdom actually in every tribulation and calamity that afflicts us. And so when we read about the people of patience and how much they endured in marriage, when we look at our problems, they really, subhanAllah, might even seem insignificant. Sheikh Musa mentioned the story about some men reaching great ranks because of nagging wives, right? So this has certainly been the case. You know, there's one story that actually popped in my mind when he mentioned this. There was this man who went to visit his friend, and this friend When he knocked on his door, his wife opened the door, and the wife was actually quite stern with him, you know, somebody of bad character. And then from a distance, he sees his friend coming from the woods, from the forest where he used to work, with animals who were ferocious animals and beasts who were actually with him and assisting him, right? And he marveled at this. Sometime in the future, he came and knocked on his door again, and he found that different wife, and she was very polite, she was so kind. And this time when he saw him coming from the forest, there was no animals or these type of beasts who were actually with him and assisting him. So he asked about that. And he said, and this man replied that this first wife I had, I bore patiently with her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded me by subjugating these animals to me. And then when I changed my wife and I married this wonderful lady who's got such good akhlaq and adab and everything, mashallah, then that disappeared. You see, so it's not without reward. Okay, we might not see that, right? If we're not at that level of wilaya. But the point is that there's no tribulation or calamity that you go through except that there's reward for your patience. And we know that if we keep the perspective of the hereafter in our mind, and we know that the ultimate reward is in the hereafter, that's fine. I can handle this little difficulty. It's not a big deal. Because the ultimate reward is the ridwan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the great pleasure, the na'im, and the bliss of al-jannah. And so this perception really enables us to handle all of these difficulties that we might experience. We cannot expect a marriage of roses without thorns. As a spouse, we need to appreciate our husband, show gratitude. And so not the case that when we see something something wrong or in our perception, we say to our husbands, "Oh, I've never seen anything good from you." You see, gratitude, showing shukr and gratitude for all the blessings that your husband does for you. This is a great virtue, really, and recognizing all that he does for you, and providing for you, and giving you a roof over your head, and all the kindness that he extends to you. Showing that gratitude and appreciation towards your husband, not seeing faults and flaws. And generally speaking, this is the case with all believers. That we veil our brothers and sisters, we don't see faults. But this is more incumbent with the closest person to you, your spouse. And so, never think that you're better than other people. Of course, we know that, but don't think you're ever better than your husband. If you've got a career and you're earning perhaps slightly more than your husband, do not think that you're now better than him. But rather make him feel that you hold him in high opinion, that you hold him in high regard. And actually being aware of your own faults really humbles us. Because how can I look at the faults of other people when I'm so full of my own faults? Like, how can I even, you know, gaze at the deficiency of another when I've got this issue, and I've got this issue, and I've got this issue? And you can just enumerate all your faults. One of the beautiful things that you can do, and it's a practice of the pious, is take yourself to account at the end of the day. How you spent your day. If you see that you've done virtuous actions, then praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you see that you have done wrong, then seek the forgiveness and do tawbah. Seek the repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, how can we even look at somebody else's faults? And a really beautiful story which comes to mind is the story of Al-Imam Ibrahim ibn Adham, one of the great men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there was the story is that a man stayed with him. And when he was about to leave, he asked Imam Ibrahim, "If you found any fault with me, let me know what it is." And then the Imam answered him I have found no fault with you because I looked at you with the eye of love. I looked at you with the eye of love and therefore only seen good in you. Therefore, ask somebody else. Go ask somebody else what your faults are. I only saw good from you. And so with this in mind, we have the verses, the eye of love is blind to any fault, while the eye of spite reveals every error. And this is, we have this phrase in our society, that love is blind. That if we truly loved our spouses for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we would not see a fault. Really, we would not, because we will always interpret everything in the best way. Find excuses for your spouse. Find excuses for brothers and sisters at large. This is the beauty of this religion. And when you, and obviously, if there are issues, then we have recourse to ulama, scholars, that are issues of pressing concerns that we can seek guidance on, of course, always. Another point that I want to mention is lowering demands and expectations, inshallah ta'ala, and Imam Afroz talked about this also. The great beauty of not having expectations is that you'll never be disappointed. Really, if you actually go into marriage thinking, I'm not expecting a thing, and you have this mindset, you'll never be disappointed. And in fact, whatever you see of good from your spouse, alhamdulillah, this is wonderful, he's so amazing, I didn't expect this. So this is the really beauty of not demanding or asking him of anything. One of the things that, you know, women get accused of is that we're too demanding. Like, we want, you know, a bag that comes out in, you know, latest fashion, or some clothes or dresses. The thing is that, and this goes back to the point of contentment, is that if we're content, we're not going to be so demanding on our husbands. So every time a new bag comes in fashion, well, I need that bag. The question is, do you really need it? You see, there's a difference between want and need, right? Need is a necessity, which your husband is, you know, he's obliged to fulfill all your responsibilities, all your needs, sorry. He's obliged to do that. However, want will never end. And so when we connect with the spiritual aspect of our religion, which teaches us contentment, which teaches us be happy with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does to you, be happy with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then alhamdulillah, your relationship will be sound. So really, tapping into that spiritual aspect of your religion will actually enhance all of your human relationships, including your marriage and your relationship with your husband. And so we're not servants of material possessions and things. We're servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're not a servant of a bag that comes into fashion. We're not a servant of dress. We're not a servant of all these things, but rather servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so with all of these beautiful virtues and etiquette, we see that really there's no room for complaint. How can we complain when we see everything coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You see, our choice is the obedience to Him, the ta'ah, the fulfilling of all the obligations. But when it comes to the dunya, we leave the expectations. We don't be demanding. But we understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending me these things. And we show gratitude to our husband for being the means of that. So these were some of the points that I wanted to mention. Obedience, of course, to the husband, that's just... I'm sure we're all aware of that. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and this beautiful deen clarified those aspects. And it's never some sort of tyrannical dictatorship, we understand. marriage is very beautiful. Husbands working together for that goal of the hereafter and the ma'rifah and the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the heaviest thing to weigh on the scales of the day of resurrection will be good character. Good character. And he also furthermore elucidated that I was sent to perfect good character. So with so much emphasis on good character, inshallah ta'ala, I pray that the session, that these talks, inshallah ta'ala, motivate, inspire us to really improve our characters and really assess our relationship that we have with people, inshallah ta'ala, reckon ourselves before we are reckoned on that ultimate day when we will stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of you for listening and increase you all. Jazakumullah khairan.